Alito, welcome back to my channel. Today is an exciting day. I'm actually making two videos for you. I won't get them posted today, but if you're like, hey, I think she was wearing that in the last video, yeah. But I just had to film this video because yay, I am finished with Camp NaNoWriMo. Yay, I met my goal. And I just wanted to share an overview of my NaNoWriMo experience. And here it is. So I finished. That's the exciting part. My goal was to put in 30 hours of writing, editing, and revisions on my novel. And I did this. I put in the 30 hours. So that's a lot of writing time, and I should be super excited about it. And on one hand, I am. And on the other hand, I have to say, in all honesty, that I did put in the hours, but I am not finished with that edit. I am so far from finished that it's kind of hard to be excited about the fact that I put in 30 hours because I don't feel that I really have a lot of content to show for that. And the reason for that is simply because I was unprepared for the editing progress, for the editing process. I was not prepared. I did not do enough research. I did not allow myself enough time to kind of let my manuscript rest before I dove into it. And I basically got really overwhelmed by the amount of changes that I needed to make. So what I had to do is actually step back and do some research on editing your rough draft, whatever you want to call it, and really put a plan in place. Now, so I did a read through of my novel. I made some basic notes on some things that needed to change. I discovered some major plot holes and I solved them. I discovered some major plot holes that didn't exist. That's right. I spent 3 days going over an issue that I thought I had really messed up on, but it turns out it wasn't a problem at all. I was second guessing myself. I don't know really how to explain that, but that's what happened. And so that really, really was hard. But once I was over that hump and I discovered a way to use Scrivener, which is the writing software that I use, to keep track of my progress on my edits. And so I will do a video about that because it might be helpful to you and you can see exactly how I did it. So once I implemented this process, which gave me tangible daily goals to meet, which for me as a writer is something that I have to have daily goals. And for me, it really, word count works. And I feel, but when you're editing, you're deleting words. So you're deleting so much and you're writing so much that it's really hard to have that as a goal. And I think that's one of the things that just made me really feel like I wasn't making progress because of that. But I'm overcoming that. It's still a little bit of an issue. I'm not going to lie. But I'm in a much better editing place. And I think that I know, I'm learning as I go, but I know now how to kind of set these little goals and how to measure my progress so that I don't get discouraged. Because I am the type of person that if I'm not meeting a goal, if I cannot see results, if I'm not able to track what I am doing, then I feel like I'm not making any progress at all. And then that leads to this like perfectionism, procrastination circle that just is terrible. And I hate it. I hate it with a passion. But that's just part of it. You have to learn as a writer. You have to grow. You have to learn new things. And I think I was unprepared for the editing process because I have spent so much of my life studying writing, reading writing books, taking classes, practicing, and just putting so much time and effort into writing that I have never really gotten to that editing stage where you're taking your work and you're perfecting it. And I hadn't studied much on that. So I'm kind of learning as I go. And so I'm really trying to remind myself that even though I have not finished the edit of my novel in the 30 days, and there's no way, I know we have a few days left of April, but there is no way. I mean, like, I think at the rate I am going, it will take me forever to edit it, but it's getting faster. And so I'm hopeful about that. And oh my goodness. Okay, so just hang with me here. I have a point, I promise. It's hard and I don't like it, but it's also fun. And so what I'm doing is I'm turning around my thought process on it. Instead of seeing it as hard and horrible and getting stuck in trying to make it perfect, what I'm doing with each draft, because I know there are many edits left to come, I know that I'm just making the novel better at this point. I'm not focusing on getting it perfect. And I'm taking it one little chunk at a time. And I'm only allowing myself a certain amount of time on each section. Because I spent 2 weeks just combing back over the first two chapters and rewriting and editing. And I am happy with what I have. But at the same time, I don't feel that I made the best use of my time. I think that if I focus on, going through the manuscript and looking for certain things, changing those certain things, and then going back through it, because there are going to be so many things I think that are still going to change between now and that final draft, that if I get hung up on the little perfectionisms of it, I mean, it's going to take forever. So that is what I have learned. Camp has been interesting. It's been fun. I set a very unrealistic goal that I was very unprepared for, and I still made progress. I'm further along than I was before. I'm more knowledgeable than I was before. And I did pick a super busy month to do it in. My birthday month, my daughter's birthday. I had to work out of state. I was originally going to do like 40 hours of just drive time getting to work and back. But I actually ended up not working the full time at my other job. Just because there was no way I was going to be able to get the progress done that I needed on my novel. And it wasn't a very busy tournament that I was working. So it just wasn't working out to be my priority, so I adjusted that. And that's a lot of information. I don't know if you really needed to know all that, but I did just really want to give you a update on my progress on my novel and let you know that I haven't given up. I won camp, yay! I did not finish editing the novel, but that's okay because I have a more realistic goal. I have a more realistic timeline. And that book, when you finally get to read it, is going to be awesome. It's going to be the best product that I can put out. And you are going to love it, I hope. No, you are going to love it. It's going to be awesome. Anyway, so that is my camp update. And I am thank you for joining me. Sorry for the ramble. I will try to edit out some of this nonsense that doesn't make any sense. But I just want to encourage you today that if you are struggling with your writing or whatever goal it is in your life, do not beat yourself up. Do not get stuck in that perfectionism loop. Just keep making progress, keep moving forward, and you will get to where you want to be. So thank you for tuning in or listening to my video. And please subscribe. Like my channel, follow me on social media because I absolutely love, love, love to connect with other readers and writers. And your feedback is so important to me. Your comments, your ideas are super important. And I really hope that I am providing something that's helpful to you in your own journey, whatever that may be. And that's it. I'm out. Have a fantastic week, and I will see you next time. Thank you.